If I don't have headphones on, I'm not working. And if I'm going to wear headphones all day, I want the best headphones in the world. And those are the Hi-Fi Man HE6. So what's good about these is, first of all, they're open. They're open-backed. So if you play music, the entire world will hear a tinny version of your music pretty loudly. So if you're working in an office with other people, you can't wear open headphones. Please don't. Please don't be that person. And that includes everything from Grado. Sorry, Grado people. But if you're working in an office alone, you can do open, and boy, the sound quality is amazing.
What do you listen to?
I'm sorry. I listen to Fish. Mostly Fish. Lots of Fish. I have 34 days worth of Fish. This is most of their albums and every live show they've played since 2009. What I like about them is that they are pretty consistent. The music, just, I like the music to begin with. And they release every concert they do, and they tour a lot. Every concert they do, they release it on their website and you can buy it for like 10 bucks. So that's where all this came from. And so it's like getting a new album from the band you like 10 times a year or more. It's great. So then while I'm working, I can put one of these shows on. I don't do shuffle, I just play straight through. I can put one of these shows on, and then I don't have to think about my music for the next 36 days.
Tell me about your keyboard.
This is the Microsoft Sculpt Ergonomic desktop keyboard.
Microsoft?
Yeah. Microsoft makes the best ergonomic keyboards. They have for years. If not ever, they really, you know, if you want the kind of split design, basically in my first few years of working, sorry about the dirtiness of it, in my first few years of working professionally as a programmer, I started to develop some wrist soreness and I was afraid of RSI issues. And so I made a couple of minor changes. The biggest one was I switched to a split keyboard, and I haven't, that was 10 years ago, and I haven't had any problems since.
Just normal?
Yeah.
Yeah, you rest it on that, or are they resting?
That's
kind of
spongy. I'll put my elbow on this sometimes. That's why it's all crunched up, because I'll often sit like this, like if I'm thinking about a problem, or if I'm browsing something, it's nice and comfortable there.
It's kind of spongy for people that can't.
Yeah, it's like a little, like, you know, it's a fake leather pad, you know, yeah. it's fine.
And your mouse there, you got a normal mouse.
Yep, the Apple Magic Mouse, nothing special. I like the inertial scrolling on it.
Yeah. And a piece of gold or something there that it sits on?
Yeah, it's this crappy Teflon pad that just, it makes it glide really easily because it's just a sheet of Teflon. I ordered it from some crazy internet supplier for like 10 bucks at some point in the past.
Look, there's Hops. Hops is up.
Hi, Hops. Temporarily up.
Hey, Hops.
Good boy.
So what computer are you running here?
This is the 5K iMac from last year. It's the 1 year old model. And I love it. It's the best computer I've ever owned by far. Absolutely love it. It's fast, the screen is gorgeous, it's huge, everything I want. If I'm editing podcasts, I'll have like Adobe Audition running, or Logic, depending on what I'm doing, probably Logic actually. And then most of the time, if I'm doing Overcast work, then I'll have Xcode running. And then this is the iOS simulator running here. And so when you're making iOS apps, Apple gives you this little simulated window here, so you can actually run the whole app right here in a window, and it's just like having a little iPhone on your computer, so it's great. So over here is all the source code, and there's this giant list of all the files. This isn't even all of them. It's Overcast has a lot of files and a lot of lines of code. This is one file over here. You can see how long it is, and this is granted a pretty important one, a pretty big one. But
what does that one do?
This is the main streaming player. This is how the streaming player works, of like, you know, getting the data from the source and putting it through the decoder and decoding MP3s into sound, decoding, you know, M4As, et cetera, and then being able to stream it without having the whole file downloaded. So this is part of that. This isn't even all of that, this is part of that.
They're really the only two things you need to make a cool app. You just need those two things, that's it really.
Basically, I mean, you can go into, you know, graphical programs to make the assets for it, to make the icons and stuff like that. But most of the work is right here. It's Xcode and a simulator. That's most of the work.
And hardware-wise, things like servers and that sort of stuff, what do you need for that?
It depends. I mean, you need like a terminal window, basically. You know, you need like terminals to... I always have terminals running. terminals running here and, monitoring your stuff. But most apps don't even need servers anymore. You know, for the most part, people don't really use... Most apps, except for like, you know, big web services, those will use servers, of course, but I don't think a lot of people use servers anymore. This is basically audio stuff. So this is a headphone amp. This is, it's by a company called Shit. Yes. And
is that written on there? Hang on.
This is their logo. It's S-C-H-I-I-T.
Okay, right.
But it is pronounced shit. So this is my shit headphone amp. And this is the DAC. I'm still not entirely sure I believe in audiophile DACs, but I got one anyway just in case. And then over on this side, I have my podcasting setup. So I have my podcasting microphone, the Neumann KMS-105, a shit word, yes, which is a USB filter. I have a whining dog. And this is my my microphone interface, the USB Pre-2, on top of a Mac Mini home server and a Blu-ray reader for some reason. I bought the Blu-ray reader thinking I'd be ripping all my movies and converting them so I could watch them, you know, on a NAS and watch them on my Apple TV. And yeah. In practice, I have not done that because it's a pain in the butt. I am not a hard worker. I do a lot, but I don't have a lot of consistency in my hours. I don't have a ton of discipline. Like when or where I do things. I just kind of do things whenever I can and whenever I'm up to it. And I just kind of tackle problems with that in mind. So like I won't tackle a problem that requires constant input from me or, you know, tons of dedicated scheduling or tons of other people to be involved. I don't hire other people. I don't have any employees because I would be a terrible manager of other employees and I would probably do less work than them and that would be weird. I generally just do what I can with my one slacker self.
Are you a good model then? Should people think that's the way to do it? Or are you a terrible role model?
All I've done, I mean, I did terribly in school and everything. Like, all I've done is found a way that I can take my slacker self and earn a living. I have no idea what will work for other people. And that's on a screen called Nitpicky Details. Every time I do things like this, I think it's a risk, and I think maybe it'll turn off some people. And every time I think things work, but no one really notices my job. I look back on it kind of the way I look back on college. It's like, it's something, it's a